So Timestripe is a powerful tool that allows you to zoom out on your planning to help you to better manage your tasks. Now today, I'm going to be doing a full review of it, giving you the pros, cons, and whether it's worth it for you. So welcome, my name is Francesco and welcome to the channel. If you're interested in becoming a subscriber, you can do because you can find out more tools and resources. But my recommendation is to jump over to toolfinder.co if you're exploring to-do list apps or more. And we also have a free buyer's guide to to-do list apps linked below in case you're exploring the best options for you. And Timestripe has come up on that list. So Timestripe, since I last reviewed it, has changed quite rapidly. At the moment, we're going to start with pricing to dive into things. So for pricing, they have a deal on at the moment, which prices themselves at $4.50 per month, which is an annual pricing, which is around $54, if my maths is right. But normally they're priced at $9 per month, and that works out at just over $100 a year. Now, I don't think that's incredibly mad with the pricing, and a good option if you're looking for that, a mid-tier to-do list application. Now, why is Timestripe slightly different? Well, there's something that's different about this, right? You can see your today, but you can also see your life goals. Now, that's pretty crazy, being able to zoom out that far. And what's nice as well is I could clock my life goals and how they correlate to my year, month, week, and so on. It's also got a calendar ability in allowing to add items. You can also add sub goals as part of it and add attachments, descriptions, making them micro documents as you work. Now, there are other abilities in it as well. More recently, in their 3.0 update, they introduced this calendar feature, which allows you to see stuff as more of a calendar, which a lot of people like. And there are some very crazy features in here, like insights, allowing you to see what was completed and how active you were across the year, and a gallery view, allowing you to see other boards and climbs, which is a way to import habits automatically into your daily routine. So you want to do 30 days of coding, it'll populate that for you and get that into your task management system, which is very good. So you can go into a separate board to plan, and you can even share this board with other people now, which is a newly released feature, allowing you to collaborate with other people. And there's an even a new progress area, allowing you to see what you did during the day. But you can assign stuff to other people, collaborate, comment, and share notes together if that's something you did want to do with your coworkers. Probably best for small teams. Before we continue, do make sure to check out our guide to to-do list apps. It'll be linked below. It's free and you can explore more there. So this is a little preview of that team mode. You can have an inbox for your team. You can also invite other people and start assigning them, which is great as a way to organize your workload. Now, if you and your team did want to find some more templates, there are better ones like OKRs, GTD, Agile, and much more that you can copy and implement into your Timestripe account. So you can use a Timestripe basic account to get things going, but there are some limitations. For example, you do have limitations to how many goals, boards, sub goals, and other such details that you have as part of your account. So if you find this a little bit overwhelming, you can reduce the amount of things you see on the sidebar, but you can also add to it as well. There is this old clock feature. So there is an old clock feature which allows you to see a clock in the craziest manner ever. So let me dive into the pros and cons of this. Now, if you're somebody that is process orientated, maybe wants to zoom out, be a bit more holistic in 2025 and beyond, then this is great because you can see your goals for the long term with your goals for the short term and align them. This is something that commonly happens in task management where you just start focusing on stuff that doesn't need to be focused on and you lose sight of that long-term goal. This is gonna help you do that by reversing them and keeping them in mind. So if you're somebody that's struggling with that, that is a massive pro to the experience. You've also got habits in there, which is gonna be helpful, boards for helping you to plan things, and a calendar view for those visual thinkers. So that's what I think the pros are. The cons are, is that this application might be a little bit overwhelming for a lot of people. There's a lot going on, and the application does center a lot of stuff around goals and sub goals, and that might not be right for you. You might want a more linear focus to your task management and something that's a little bit more robust in other ways in terms of what apps it's available on and things like that, as there are some limitations to that. So that was an overview of Timestripe, best for those who want a more holistic to-do list application that now allows you to plan with other people and has a calendar view. So that was my review. Hopefully it helped you pick whether the best one. If you are still stuck or you're still working out which one's for you, jump over to toolfinder.co and we've got loads of task management apps there. I promise you, tons. and I'd love to help you find them and find the right one this year.